Okay. Well, you wonder why I always dress in black, why you never see bright colors on my back. You wonder why does my appearance seem to have a somber tone. Well, there's a reason for the things that I have on. I wear the black for the poor and the beaten down, living in the hopeless, hungry side of town. I wear it for the prisoner who has long paid for his crime, but is there because he's a victim of the times. I wear the black for those who never read, nor listened to the words that Jesus said about the way to happiness through love and charity. I believe he's talking straight to you and me. Well, we're doing mighty fine, I do suppose, in our streak of lightning cars and fancy clothes. But just so we're reminded of the ones who are held back, up front there ought to be a man in black. I wear the black for the sick and the lonely old, for the reckless ones whose bad trip left them cold. I wear it for another 100,000 who've died, believing that we all were on their side. Well, there's things that never will be right, I know, and things need changing anywhere you go. But till we start to make a move to make a few things right, you'll never see me wear a suit of white. Oh, I'd love to wear a rainbow every day and tell the world that everything's okay. But I'll try to carry off a little darkness on my back till things are brighter. I'm a man in black.
Five years, it couldn't be, but it is. And tonight we're going to look back over a quarter of a century, and some things are as clear as the day that they happened. There was a day in 1955 that I'll never forget. I was 23 years old and not too long out of the Air Force. Sun Records had just released the first record by Johnny Cash and the Tennessee Two. That was Marshall Grant and Luther Perkins. Well, I took that big 78 RPM record to a Memphis radio station and gave it to a disc jockey that I'd been listening to for years, even way before I was in the Air Force. He was the very first one to ever play a Johnny Cash record on the air. And tonight, he's right here, and that really makes me very glad. He's now one of Nashville's leading talent agents, my friend, Mr. Bob Neal. The song that Bob Neal played that first day in 1955 was the first of a lot of railroading songs that I've done over the years. I'd written it kind of a sentimental thing about my return from Air Force back to the South. It's called Hey Porter. Hey Porter, hey Porter, would you tell me the time? How much longer will it be till we cross that Mason-Dixon line? At daylight, would you tell that engineer to slow it down? Or better still, just stop the train, cause I want to look around. Hey, Porter, hey, Porter, what time did you say? How much longer will it be till I can see the light of day? When we hit Dixie, would you tell that engineer to ring his bell? And ask everybody that ain't asleep to stand right up and yell. Oh, Bob Wood. Marshall Grant. W.S. Holland on the drums. Hey, Porter, hey, Porter, it's getting light outside. The
this old train is puffing smoke and I have to strain my eyes. But ask that engineer if he will blow his whistle, please, 'cause I smell frost on cotton leaves and I feel that southern breeze. Hey, porter, please get my bags for me. I need nobody to tell me now that we're in Tennessee. Go tell that engineer to make that lonesome whistle scream. We're not so far from home, so take it easy on the speed. Earl Bob on the piano, Jerry Hensley, Jack Hale and Bob Lewis. Hey porter, please open up the door. When they stop this train, I'm gonna get off first, 'cause I can't wait no more. Tell that engineer I said thanks a lot and I didn't mind the fare. Gonna set my feet on southern soil and breathe that southern air.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, Kris Kristofferson.
Bruce. Thank you. Say, I want to tell y'all a story about Johnny Cash. It goes back to when I was making my living at the Columbia Studios here in Nashville where John was recording. And I was writing songs, too. I wasn't supposed to pitch them to the stars, but of course I did anyway. But I wasn't having a whole lot of luck. So when I had this song that I wanted John to sing real bad, I decided I'd take it out to his house in his old National Guard helicopter that I happened to be flying, and I landed it on his lawn. And at the time, that was sort of like landing on the roof of his house. Well, John, I think, was pretty amazed by it. He was easily spooked back in those days. And whether out of fear or curiosity, he not only agreed to listen to the song, and it was a hit. And I got to lay down the broom, and I also made a friend for life. Thanks again, John.
Will you get that helicopter out of my yard now and sing a song with me, all right?
I'll sing a song.
Let's do it.
Well, I woke up Sunday morning with no weight up on my head. That didn't hurt. And the beer I had for breakfast wasn't bad, so I had one more for dessert. Then I fumbled through my closet for my clothes and found my cleanest dirty shirt. Then I washed my face and combed my hair, stumbled down the stairs to meet the day.
I'd smoked my brain the night before on cigarettes and songs that I'd been picking. But I lit my first and watched a small kid cussing at a can that he was kicking. Then I crossed the empty street and caught the Sunday smell of someone frying chicken. Lord, it took me back to something that I'd lost somehow, somewhere along the way.
On a Sunday morning sidewalk, wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. Something in a Sunday makes a body feel alone. There's nothing short of dying half as lonesome as the sound of a sleeping city sidewalk. Sunday morning coming down.
In the park I saw a daddy with a laughing little girl who he was swinging. And I stopped beside a Sunday school and listened to the song that they were singing.
Then I headed back for home, somewhere far away a lonely bell was ringing. And it echoed through the canyon like a disappearing dream of yesterday. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. 'Cause there's something in a Sunday makes your body feel alone. And there's nothing short of dying, oh, half as lonesome as the sound of a sleeping city sidewalk Sunday morning coming down. Ladies and gentlemen, my favorite singing partner, my best friend, my lady, June Carter Cash. June, you know, there goes 25 years for me in the music business. Would you try 25 more with me?
I'd love to, if you don't mess up.
I'd like to live out all our dreams, and if I could, yes, if I could, the nicest one would be with you, and you'd be here with me. Don't you ever get lonely.
Lord, I'm no good when you're away. What can they expect from a girl who loved you like I've loved you? Won't you ever just get tired? Come on.
Don't you ever get lonely. You're a part of me that I can't do without. You're a part of me that dreams are all about. But you can't hold on to something that you've never had before. Love waits for the wind to bring you back again. Take me away.
Friends say it's great now you're a star. What can they expect from a girl who loved you just the way you were?
Oh, and late at night, how I wish things had never changed and you were here with me. Don't you ever get lonely. You're a part of me that I can't do without. You're a part of me that dreams are all about. But you can't hold on to something that you've never had before. Love waits for the wind to bring you back again. Take me away. Take me away.
Take me away.
Take me away. You know, it's nice to sing a love song with someone when you really mean it, and I really mean it.
Well, you know something? I really mean it, too.
June Carter Cash. That's a pretty lady. And there was another lady in my life, a very important lady in my personal and professional life, a fishing buddy, a darling mother-in-law, and a country music legend, Mother Maybelle Carter.
Now it's hard to turn around and look back down that long road I've just traveled. Cause nights never end in bog twine, my dreams have come unraveled. Now as evening lays a shawl across the shoulders of my life, I find I couldn't tie my life together with guitar strings and a boy's heartfelt line. And I'm glad I wasn't there to hear my mama, cause I know she cried for hours. I still hear her saying to me, get your guitar and pick the wildwood flowers.
Train a-coming, it's rolling around the bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on. But that train keeps rolling on down to San Antonio. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. When I hear that whistle blowing, I hang my head and cry. There's rich folks eating in a fancy dining car. They're probably drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. Well, I know I had it coming. I know I can't be free. But those people keep a moving, and that's what tortures me. Well, if they freed me from this prison, if that railroad train was mine, bet I'd move it on a little farther down the line. Far from Folsom Prison, that's where I want to stay. And I'd let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away.
Ladies and gentlemen, Waylon Jennings.
Hey, Waylon. Remember when me and you used to room together?
Yeah, I do, Waylon. About 12 years ago, 13.
Was that long ago?
I believe it was.
I tell you, this guy is the sloppiest housekeeper in the world.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
But he's a pretty good cook. And he wore black when he cooked, too. But he's been a good friend, and still is.
So have you, buddy. Thank you.
Yeah. I always wanted to sing a song about prisons with you.
Really? Let's do it.
All right, let's do it. Well, it ain't a-raining back home.
bet your sister's still on the phone. I bet mama's in the kitchen cooking fried chicken, wishing that I hadn't done wrong.
Oh, but don't you worry about it none, though, mama. Everything's gonna be all right, mama. They're teaching us a lot of new things in here, things like...
There ain't no good in an evil-hearted woman, and I ain't cut out to be no Jesse James. And you don't go writing hot checks down in Mississippi, and there ain't no good change in it. Yesterday's May, wishing that the hay was all bale. I bet he's wishing we could go fishing. Here I am laying in jail.
Oh, but Papa, don't you worry about it now. Everything's gonna be all right. They're teaching us a lesson a day, and we're learning pretty well, too. We already learned a whole lot of stuff already. Stuff like,
there ain't no James. And you don't go writing hot checks down in Mississippi, and there ain't no good change. There ain't no good in an evil-hearted woman, and I ain't cut out to be no Jesse James. And you don't go writing hot checks down in Mississippi, and there ain't no good change. And you don't go writing hot checks down in Mississippi, and there ain't no good change.
Chet Atkins. Hey, Chet. How you doing?
I'm doing fine.
Thanks for being with us.
Thank you, Johnny. I'm happy to be here representing the many musicians of Local 257 here in Nashville, who are very happy to have you as one of their members, and they want to present you with this plaque.
Well, thank you very much.
And I'd like to read it to you. I'll need these first.
Okay.
To Johnny Cash, in recognition and appreciation of 25 years of professional musicianship and loyalty to the American Federations of Musicians and Local 257, Nashville, Tennessee, and it's signed by our president, Johnny D. George, and Dutch Gordon, the Secretary Treasurer. Congratulations.
Thanks, Chet. Yeah.
Thank
you very much. I appreciate you being out with us, man.
Good acting.
Good acting. Thank you very much. Chet Atkins and Waylon Jennings, two of the people in my life that I've been most fortunate to know. You know, in a quarter of a century, I've sung about railroads, and I've sung about prisons, and I've sung about America.
If you get the feeling that you're in an old deserted building, you are. I guess you could almost call it a shrine. The official name is the Ryman Auditorium, but America knew it as the Grand Ole Opry. From the time that music first takes hold of a country boy, he dreams of the day when he and his music can come to Nashville. For me, that dream was to someday stand on this stage, and that dream came true. I stood where Hank Williams had stood, and Tex Ritter, and Roy Acuff, and Red Foley. With its stained glass windows and benches, it's been called the Mother Church of Country Music. I can tell you, it's really a thrill to be back here tonight. This old place is American as apple pie, and so is this song I'd like to do for you. I walked through a county courthouse square, and on a park bench an old man was sitting there. I said, "Your old courthouse is kind of run down." He said, "No, it'll do for our little town." I said, "Your old flagpole's kind of leaned a little bit, and that's a ragged old flag you got hanging on it." He said, "Have a seat," and I sat down. "Is this the first time you've come to our little town?" I said, "I think it is." He said, "I don't like to brag, but we're kind of proud of that ragged old flag. You see, we got a little hole in that flag there when Washington took it across the Delaware. And it got powder burned the night Francis Scott Key sat up watching it writing, "Say, can you see?" And it got a little rip in New Orleans with Pakenham and Jackson tugging at its seams. And it almost fell at the Alamo beside the Texas flag, but she waved on, though. It got cut with a sword at Chancellorsville, got cut again at Shiloh Hill. There was Robert E. Lee, Beauregard, and Bragg, and the south wind blew hard on that ragged old flag. On Flanders Field in World War I, she took a bad hole from a Bertha gun. She turned blood red in World War II. She hung limp and low by the time that one was through. She was in Korea, Vietnam. She went where she was sent by her Uncle Sam. She waved from our ships upon the briny foam, and now we've about quit waving her back here at home. And in her own good land here, she's been abused, she's been burned, dishonored, denied, refused, and now the very government for which she stands is scandalized throughout the land. And she's getting threadbare, and she's wearing kind of thin. But she's in good shape for the shape she's in. Because she's been through the fire before, and she can take a whole lot more. So we raise her up every morning, and we bring her down slowly every night. We don't let her touch the ground, and we fold her upright. On second thought, I guess I do like to brag, 'cause I'm mighty proud of that ragged old flag.
Chris Christopherson.
John, I wanted to come back out at this point in the show to remind the people out there of one highlight in Johnny Cash's career that you might be a little reluctant to discuss.
Oh, really? Dare I ask what it might be?
It's not one of those horror stories of the old days. No, it was the 1969 Country Music Association Awards. And I got to say, Hoss, you cleaned the decks on that one.
Hey there, number six, this is your Johnny Cash and Gene Perry. Would you believe, one of my best friends, the guy I done my first tour with, Mr. Johnny Cash, of Memphis.
More vocalist of the year, Johnny Cash.
A boy named Sue.
Johnny Cash.
Well, my daddy left home when I was three. He didn't leave very much for my mom and me. Just his old guitar and an empty bottle of booze. Now, I don't blame him 'cause he run and hid, but the meanest thing that my daddy ever did was before he left, he went and named me Sue. Well, he must have thought that it was quite a joke, and it got a lot of laughs from lots of folks. Seems I had to fight my whole life through. Some gal would giggle and I'd turn red, and some guy'd laugh and I'd bust his head. I'll tell you, life ain't easy for a boy named Sue. Well, I grew up quick and I grew up mean. My fists got hard, my wits got keen. Roamed from town to town to hide my shame. But I made me a vow to the moon and stars, I'd search the honky-tonks and bars and kill that man that give me that awful name. Well, it was Gatlinburg in mid-July, and I just hit town and my throat was dry. Thought I'd stop and have myself a brew. At an old saloon on a street of mud, and there at a table dealing stud, sits a dirty mangy dog that named me Sue. Well, I knew that snake was my own sweet dad from a worn-out picture that my mother'd had. I knew that scar on his cheek and his evil eye. He was big and bent and gray and old, and I looked at him and my blood ran cold, and I said, "My name is Sue. How do you do? Now you're gonna die." Well, I hit him hard right between the eyes, and he went down, but to my surprise, come up with a knife and cut off a piece of my ear. Then I busted a chair right across his teeth, and we crashed through the walls and into the street, kicking and gouging in the mud and blood and beer. Well, I'll tell you, I fought tougher men, but I really can't remember when. He kicked like a mule and he bit like a crocodile. I heard him laughing and I heard him cuss, and he went for his gun, but I pulled mine first. He stood there looking at me and I saw him smile. And he said, son, this world is rough, and if a man's gonna make it, he's gotta be tough. And I knew I wouldn't be there to help you along. So I give you that name and I said goodbye, and I knew you'd have to get tough or die. It's that name that helped to make you strong. Said, now you just fought one heck of a fight, and I know you hate me and you got the right to kill me now, and I wouldn't blame you if you do. But you ought to thank me before I die for the gravel in your gut and the spit in your eye, cause I'm the named you Sue. What could I do? What could I do? Well, I got all choked up and I threw down my gun. I called him a pa and he called me a son. Come away with a different point of view. And I think about it now and then, every time I try and every time I win. And if I ever have a boy, well, I had a boy and I named him John Carter, and he looks a lot like his mama, but he's crazy about his daddy. Thank you. For all of the past 25 years, this man has been with me, ladies and gentlemen, my bass player and my friend, Marshall Grant. It's a long time, isn't it, Marshall?
More like 26 now, John.
Yeah, that's right. You know, the year before we cut our first record, I was 22 years old. Just home from the Air Force, and my brother Roy took me down to a garage in Memphis and introduced me to two guys that worked there, and that was the start of Johnny Cash and the Tennessee Two. One was Marshall Grant, and the other was the late Luther Perkins, and he was with us every step of the way for the first 13 years, Luther Roy. Terrific. I'd like to tell you folks about some other good friends of mine, the Statler Brothers.
John, we don't want you to tell them about us. We'd like to tell them about you. We've got a song for you, okay?
Okay, I'd love to hear it. Thank you.
It started March of 64, 16 years ago. We were hired by Johnny Cash to open up his show.
Down to Nashville to Columbia Studios. Not knowing where we came from, they told us where to go. But Johnny said, I like those boys, don't you give them no trash. You see, we were Johnny's little boys, and we got paid by cash.
Concert stage and watched him write his songs, and saw the things we had to do and the things that could go wrong. And if we had to start again, we'd do it in a flash, cause we learned more than we earned when we got paid by cash.
Then came a time when our career demanded that we go. Through some tears we all shook hands at last and final show. All those years we never had a contract or a clash. Whatever we may be to day. We owe it all to cash.
We were there when Jimmy came, Johnny's mother cried. And we sang to him that morning, our buddy Luther died. And we were there when the son was born that filled them both with pride.
John will tell you there were years when times were good and bad, but we can tell you they were some of the best we ever had. Carl Perkins and the Carters and the Tennessee Three. We were one big happy family and would have done it all for free. Don't, 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 don't,
ladies and gentlemen, my friend Carl Perkins.
Hey, buddy.
Hi, John.
Thanks, Carl. Good to see you, buddy.
Oh, it's good to be here, John. You know, I think, John, it's time that publicly I said thanks to you for telling me about a cat named C.V. White.
Yeah, well, thank you very much, John. Just so the folks will understand, though, I once told Carl about a friend of mine in the Air Force named C.V. White. And when he'd put on his dress uniform or go to town, he'd always mention how he wished that he was wearing his favorite civilian outfit, especially his blue suede shoes.
Right on.
And that gave Carl an idea.
Yeah, wrote a song about it.
And it did mighty well. Millions of records for Carl Perkins, and then millions of records for Elvis Presley, of course. Right now, here's a couple of old rockabillies. That's what they called us back then, wasn't it?
They did, son.
Singing that big hit of Carl Perkins, Blue Suede Shoes.
Come here for it.
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready now. Go, 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 don't you step on my blue suede shoes.
Yeah, you can do anything, lay hold on my blue suede shoes. Well, you can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. Do anything that you want to do, but John, lay hold. Yeah, you can do anything with that all on my blue suede shoe.
Play a little guitar, Carl.
Pick it now. From an old fruit jar. Do anything that you want to do, but children lay off of them shoes and don't step in my blue suede shoes. Yeah, they all can do anything, but they all on my blue suede shoes. Let's say it together, kids. Here we go.
Well, it's blue, 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 blue suede shoes, baby. Blue, blue, blue suede shoes, baby. Blue, blue, blue suede shoes, baby. Blue, blue, blue suede shoes.
And now, here are Chris, Johnny, Waylon, and Larry, the Million Dollar Quartet.
I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tie that binds. Because you're mine, I walk the line. I find it very, very
easy to be true. I find myself alone when each day is through. I'll admit that I'm a fool for you, because you're mine. I walk the line.
Burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire.
Love is a burning thing, and it makes a fiery ring. Bound by wild desire, I fell into a ring of fire.
Chris Christopherson from Waylon Jennings.
And now for a song that's a regular part of our concert program, and back for a reunion, June, my wife, and her sisters, Anita Carter and Helen Carter, and ladies and gentlemen, the Statler brothers, to sing again, Will the Circle Be Unbroken? Thank you very much for this evening and for the past 25 years. Thank you. God bless you and good night.